In this series, we're going to continue our examination into how to build game environments from games like Bloodborne or the Dark Souls series using game assets from our file base at gamedevhq.com. This is the second video in the series, and we're going to continue our examination of the terrain system in Unity 2018.3. Hey everyone, this is Al over at GameDevHQ.com, and every week we bring you three amazing pieces of content related to game development. Like and subscribe and check us out at GameDevHQ.com. So this is a scene that we created inspired by a Bloodborne kind of world using assets in Filebase on GameDevHQ.com and using the basic version of Unity 2018.3, which you could download for free. In this tutorial, we will learn how to paint on our terrain as well as add objects into our scene such as rocks, tombstones, and other sorts of vegetation. So we're going to be finishing out the terrain on this scene. We're gonna paint in some details. We're also going to add in rocks and grass and all the other cool stuff to make it look all pretty. If you haven't had a chance, I would suggest starting at tutorial one of this series. That way we're not kind of like skipping things that you may want to catch up on. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're going to add some paints into our terrain and start painting out materials onto here. I'm gonna first show you how to create your own terrain layer. So to create one, we wanna do a create layer, which is here under edit terrain, and you gotta make sure you're in paint texture. Clicked on your terrain, paint texture, edit terrain, go to create layer, and it's gonna look up for all your textures, right? In GDHQ, we have a couple textures on there, and we'll be adding a lot more in the future. But in this, I'm going to be looking for dirt number 4.tga, which is Targa. Double-click that, and it's going to go ahead and add the terrain in. Now, how do we find more information about this terrain? If we click this little drop-down right here, if we click on the terrain, a new layer will appear right here, and that's what it's currently named. So where is new layer? Well, new layer sits on the top right here. So I'm gonna call this dirt 4. And I'm gonna wanna grab dirt 4 and put it in my dirt 4 folder, which contains my normal and my TGA, right? So then if I go look at dirt 4, normally it comes in at 15 by 15. And whenever you have the terrain selected, you know this orange thing appears and it's kind of irritating. So go up to gizmos and turn off selection outline. So now we get to see our terrain, even though it's selected, without it being on, which clears things up a little bit. So for this terrain, it's a little bit too big. You know, we got like wood pieces and dirt and everything like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and select my dirt, and I wanna set this to maybe a 2x2. And I'm gonna try to keep most of my terrain textures around a 2x2. So as we get closer, you could see that scale-wise, it matches the crypt and the dirt. Then I wanna go ahead and drop in my normal channel. And in here, it's set to a normal channel scale of 1. But we can increase that. And you can see how the more you increase it, the stronger the shadows get, the stronger the highlights get. We definitely want to add some of that in here so that our ground doesn't feel so incredibly flat. Once that's in, and let's see, I'm going to set mine to around 5. I think that looks pretty good. We want to add in more terrains. Now, since I showed you how to create them, there's a couple that are already created. So if you've already made your terrain, go ahead and click Add Layer, and it'll show the terrains that are available that are already created and ready to go. They're kind of like this little white piece of paper, like Dirt 4. So I'm gonna go ahead and create my stone, and if I click on my stone and look at the properties, you see how my normal layers are already set in there and the scale's already set. So I'm just gonna go ahead and grab my paintbrush, which if I drop this up, I could set my brush size. Let's see, let's go try this little paintbrush view. And I'm just gonna go ahead and paint in my pathway to my crypts. So I got two crypts that I'm working on, and it's gonna be connected by this walkway. And the let's go ahead and finish it out over on this area. And from here, you know, you can actually mess with the normals and either invert it, depending on what looks best, adjust the size, adjust the scale, and have it look pretty good from there. Then I'm going to go ahead and add in another set of dirt. So I'm going to add in some mud. And this mud right here looks actually really good when you place it underneath rocks. So I'm just going to set that around the corners over there. And I actually really yanked up the normals on that. You can kind of see the normal scale in that image right there. And then I'm going to go ahead and add in a fourth, which is this layer dirt right here, dirt 8. And dirt 8 is more of like a dirt that's on the top of the mountain cliff versus on the sides. Now, another thing that I like to point out for you guys is if you click on your terrain settings right here, you can actually adjust your terrain's material channel as well. So right over here, something that's really interesting is it's currently using the built-in standard, but you can use other versions like the Legacy Diffuse or the Legacy Specular, or you can do a custom material and you can add that into your scene. Now, it may change your materials and the way they're presented in the texture. So for this instance, I'm just gonna stick with the normals, but just wanted to show you that that option does exist. The next thing I wanna do is I actually wanna start adding in some assets, some paint details into this scene. So the first thing I'm gonna look at is I'm gonna look at some of these rocks and adding these into the scene. So what do? I go ahead and click edit. And I can add a detail mesh. And the detail mesh would be rocks, and the grass would be trees. This is a texture, this is a 3D object. So you go ahead and click add detail mesh. And I'll leave this right here for you so you guys can see what's going on. I'm gonna go ahead and drop my rock inside, my rock prefab. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and click add, but then I'm gonna go back here and do I'm gonna go paint in a couple rocks. So let's go ahead to here, here, and there we go. I painted in two rocks right there. Now, I'm gonna go click edit details, and I'm gonna edit this, and here's why. So there's a minimum width and a max width. So this is the height and size of your rocks. So if you want these at like 0.5 and let's say 3, you get a far bigger range of rocks than you normally would. But the other important thing is if you do a vertex lit, now this is gonna have shading attached to it. If you do it as grass, it's not gonna have shading, it's just gonna be a texture. And if you select your healthy color and your dry color, what I like to do is I like to actually grab environmental colors so that they blend in more with your scene. Then you go ahead, hit apply. Now, if you hold shift while drawing this, you can actually delete and erase your paint details. So I'm gonna go down here to my settings and I wanna increase my brush size just a little bit. And if I just paint, you see, whew, I get a lot of rock there. But if I go to this like 0.625, I start getting a little bit of a spread of rock all around, right? You're gonna wanna go really light on these rocks, but you do wanna add them into your scene. And so I do kind of like a spurty kind of button press, so I can do quick edits and undos if they come in looking ridiculous. And then you can actually go back into this shot as well. Click on your terrain, and let's say you want to edit these rocks again, and let's say make these, I don't know, 1.5 and 1.5. You know, you could adjust your rock sizes from here, and those will adjust inside your scene. So we're going to go ahead and add some more rocks into our scene. So I'm going to go ahead and grab, let's see, rock two. Rock four is an interesting looking rock. So I'm going to set the color to vertex lit. I'm going to select these dark brown shades. Go back to my terrain, make sure I select rock four, and start adding some in. And it doesn't have to be perfect. In fact, you're going for randomness here. All right, now I'm going to add one more detail mesh. And I'm going to make sure that I get a good size for that. So let's do 1.5 and 3.5. And let's hit apply. Those may be a little too big. Okay. All right, now we're going to add in some tombstones into our scene. Turn this into a graveyard. Go to detail. We're going to go grab our tombstone and drop it in. And then hit up, set it to vertex lit, hit add. Make sure you paint in a couple. Because we want to see these before we start painting them in general. So we're going to go back to edit. And we're going to set the size down to 1 and 1. Because these things are pretty big. We may even go 0.7 to adjust it. Let's get some color variation inside of it. And we may want to go a little higher. And hit apply. And then going to hold shift and delete these, and we're just going to start placing them randomly throughout our scene. And then we're going to add another tombstone variant. Not a lot of room for dead people here, just a lot of room for tombstones. And then finally, we're going to add a third tombstone. Man, you get all of this in Filebase? Yes, you do. It's a good deal. You should buy it. $15 a month, guys. Cancel at any time. Put it all in your game, man. I can't think of a better deal in video game development right now. Besides Unity, which is free. That's a pretty good deal. Can't make this graveyard in Unity for free, though. No, sir. Look at that. We filled up our entire scene, filled with all these really cool-looking tombstones everywhere. I'm totally digging this. All right, now we need to talk vegetation. So we're going to start off with adding in this really nice-looking flower texture that I totally dig. Let's go ahead and drop in red flowers. Then I'm going to go to edit. I'm going to set these to a light color. And hit apply. Oh, it's so hard to hit them sometimes. Okay. And in this instance, I really want to set this floral arrangement, flowers all around the environment. Really going to bring this scene in together. I'm amazed how when Bloodborne did it with the ivy, it changed the entire world so quickly, and it just became alive all of a sudden. Now you may run into an issue at a certain point where you're trying to paint and you're just not getting any more information on here. That's when you go into the settings, and this is where your detail resolution is. So basically, you know, imagine this is a grid, and there's so much detail that can be filled in a 64 by 64 space. And you need to increase the resolution. So if you go to like a 32 by 32, you see how all of a sudden all these flowers appear that I've been trying to paint in. So you can set your detail resolution a little lower so you can have more, I guess, areas to paint in. And don't be afraid to clear things out to add things in just by holding the shift key. So that looks really cool right there. I think that's really starting to come together. So let's go ahead and add in our fern. Let's go ahead and edit this. Now, if we set this to grass, your AI, your PNG should work. But we're going to want to bring down the color. And then finally, I'm going to add in some grass. So we go to Edit Textures, and instead of using the Detail Mesh, we're going to use the Add Grass Texture. So in here, we need to find a 2D texture. So in the 2D mode, I have my dirt, but then I also have some grass textures. And you just drop that right into here and go ahead and click Add. And make sure you select the grass. And let's paint this in real quick so you can see what it looks like. If we go in and edit this a little bit, these are really going to be fantastic to add into the scene, especially around the tombstones. You know, those little textures, man, they really blow things up real fast. Oh, it looks so cool. You know, you get that overgrowth around the crypt, and all of a sudden it becomes real. There we go. Look at this scene right here. Isn't that a thing of beauty right there? All right, so that's pretty much it for this tutorial. I think this is a good stopping point. We got a lot of great looking stuff in this scene, and I kind of want to just take a second to step back and look at it a little bit longer before I push it any further. And then we're going to add some more objects into the scene. We need to add some railings, we need to add some more walls, we need to add some sacks, and then we can even start talking about lighting and HDRs and going from there. So this was part two. Be sure to tune in for part three next week, and we'll keep moving forward and finish up this entire environment and try to recreate a scene similar to Bloodborne. A special thanks to all the GDHQ Plus and Pro members out there. Man, your support keeps this channel alive, and we greatly appreciate it. If you could, there's a like and subscribe button right down below. Just go ahead and ring that bell. This is Al. I'm out of here. Thanks again. Have a good one.